Hi, I'm Nahid Nenshi, Mayor of Calgary. And here we are at the end of this year and at the end of this decade. 2019 has certainly been a tumultuous year. A new provincial government, a new federal government, and an economic recovery that remains more fragile than any of us would like. But regardless, your city government has been working hard this year to deliver the services you need, to keep your taxes low, and ultimately, to make sure that Calgary remains a great place to make a living and a great place to make a life. Everything we've done this year is about supporting what we're calling Calgary's comeback. We've frozen construction permit fees for the fifth year in a row. Starting in 2020, business license fees and other fees will see a 10% reduction, saving businesses a total of $1 million a year. We've set up a business advisory council, helping us really understand how to cut red tape and how to move forward with helping businesses succeed. Through our Economic Development Fund, the Opportunity Calgary Investment Fund, this year we've invested in 7 businesses and initiatives that are all about diversifying the economy, promoting innovation, and ultimately creating and growing jobs right here in Calgary. But the most important thing we can do to ensure business success is for all of us to support those local businesses. That's why we launched Buy Local YYC. And it really is about not just us doing our shopping with local merchants instead of online, but it is also about Calgary businesses looking to their own supply chains and figuring out how they can support local suppliers and creating a more resilient business ecosystem right here. And ultimately, that's how we move to a more prosperous Calgary. Helping Calgarians get around the city regardless of their choice of mode of transportation. On the road side, I think people in Southwest Calgary will be excited to know we're almost done. In fact, we have done the major work on all those road connections to connect to the Southwest Ring Road, Anderson, Southland, 90th, improve the intersection at 90th and 14th. And of course, we're also building out Airport Trail in Northeast Calgary, creating another critical east-west link across the city. In terms of transit, we continue to work on the Green Line, getting that exactly right for the largest public works project in our history. And of course, last year we launched the MAX routes, the single biggest investment in bus service in Calgary's history. And at the end of 2019, MAX Yellow joins that family, making it easier for people to get to Rocky View Hospital, Mount Royal University, and to downtown Calgary. Oh, and scooters! In terms of active mobility, one of the funnest things we did this year was work on our e-bike and e-scooter pilot. If you can believe it, 150,000 people have used the e-bikes and e-scooters, 750,000 trips. Clearly, people enjoy them, they're using them, and we're going to make some changes to that pilot project to make sure that that works even safer and even better. Our goal here is to make sure that every Calgarian lives in a neighborhood where they feel safe, but also a neighborhood that has the amenities that they need to live a great life. So for example, we've invested a lot this year in affordable housing, in building new units and helping nonprofit organizations have access to city land. I was excited about the opening of Homes for Heroes, a village of tiny homes for our veterans. And we did another example where to reduce costs on affordable housing, we used prefab homes that we built off-site and moved into neighborhoods, eliminating or at least slowing down the disruption to the neighbors during construction. You all know that we've gone into partnership with the Calgary Sports and Entertainment Corporation to create a new arena downtown, which will be an anchor of a new cultural and entertainment district, along with the expansion of the BMO Centre, which will help us create one of the largest convention centres in Calgary, attracting more and more visitors to this revitalized cultural and entertainment district. Next up, investments in the Arts Commons on the other side of the neighborhood to make sure that we really are bringing people to that vitality and excitement in the center city through downtown into East Victoria Park. It may surprise you to know that this year we celebrated the 10th anniversary of our Blue Cart program. Recycling paper alone saves 1 million trees a year. And we continue to work on great waste reduction strategies. People are seeing real differences. We have managed to take an enormous amount of waste out of our landfill. This year, Council also unanimously passed our climate strategy, making sure that we are absolutely stewarding our air, our land, and our water for now and for future generations. We've invested in Calgarians' health in other ways, particularly through recreation. Not only have we been able to keep the Beltline and Inglewood Pools open for two more years, we've also opened new recreation facilities. This year, we opened the world's largest YMCA in the community of Seton, hot on the heels of the world's second largest YMCA in Rocky Ridge. And of course, this year we celebrated the first anniversary of our extraordinary new central library. So I've chosen to make the cornerstone of my third term as mayor a creation of Calgary's first action plan on mental health and addiction. We have an addiction crisis in our community, but it goes beyond the headlines. One in four of us will be touched by mental illness in our lives. And that's why we've come together with council and with the community to create the Community Action Plan on Mental Health and Addiction, that it'll be world leading in terms of making sure that every single Calgarian has the opportunity to live a life of dignity and of opportunity. You know, I've got nearly 15,000 colleagues at the City of Calgary, and I am so proud of them and the work they do every single day. But it also means that the city needs to continue to find ways to deliver all of these services as effectively as possible. Over the last several years, we found $650 million in savings in our budget to make sure that we can continue to deliver you those services while maintaining the lowest residential taxes in the country. This year, we've also had to work really hard on the tax shift between businesses and homeowners in the city. Because of the vacancy rate in those downtown buildings, businesses outside of the downtown have seen really unsustainable increases in their taxes. We spent over $200 million in the last few years rebating and supporting those businesses through this major shift. And this year, council decided that we would put a little bit more money onto homeowners so that we could give businesses a little bit of a break, so that we could support businesses, particularly through these difficult times. This fall, I was humbled to celebrate my 9th anniversary as your mayor. That makes me the third longest serving mayor in Calgary's history, if you can believe it. But now that we're at the end of the decade and I'm reflecting back on this decade, Calgary's been through ups and downs, but ultimately we have maintained being one of the very best places in the world to live. Don't take my word for it. The Economist called us the very best city, not only in North America, but in the entire Western Hemisphere in which to live. We've never forgotten the critical thing. The people come here to build community. The people come here because this is a place where it doesn't matter where you come from or what you look like. What matters is that you're here and that you belong here, and that right here, right now, you deserve to live a great Canadian life. We spent a decade doing that together, and I know the next decade will be even better. From my family to yours, all the very best for 2020 and beyond.